What is stand-up comedy? It is a comedy performance to live audiences addressed directly on the stage. The content of stand-up comedy is often derived from life, which is often observational, ironic, and surreal. From the early 2000s, stand-up comedians are more or less like to make jokes on gender-based issues, such as Kevin Hart. In his show, we always start with a question like, did you notice that, to lead the coming up content.
Only thing that's worse than a female that doesn't trust you is a female that doesn't trust you that has no proof for why she doesn't trust you. That bitch is crazy. Let me tell you why. She's crazy because she has so many thoughts in her head about what she might be doing, and it pisses her off and she can't figure it out. That's why she sits in the house all day trying to put pieces to a puzzle together that doesn't exist. Oh, he done fucked up. Oh, this nigga fucked up. What the fuck is this right here? Oh, I got his ass now.
Kevin Hart uses this to explore the cognitive differences of different gender in life, so as to resonate with audience of different genders and to create comedy.
She look crazy as shit while she say it. Don't act like I'm fucking crazy. Let me tell you something. Any bitch that do this shit right here is a goddamn psychopath. You hear me? Any bitch that argue with you to the side, oh, you got a bitch fucked up.
But Kaisha also makes gender-related jokes in his performances. Unlike Kevin Hart, he usually plays a traditionally male character in the show. He takes off his shirt during the show and tells jokes inspired by extreme masculine thinking, and makes the audiences laugh at the image he created.
Stop what? She goes, I got my period. I'm like, bitch, you promised. I'm like, you called the wrong number, dickhead. Call your mom. She's like, Dad, I need you right now. Immediately as a parent, I'm melting down. So I'm like, she's freaking out at school. She's by herself. She's going through what Georgia went through. This isn't my skill set. But I got this. I go, okay, baby. All right. Okay. How'd you get it?
As the so-called second gender, it is much harder for females to succeed in the field of stand-up comedy. Even though stand-up comedy shows originated from the West in early 20th century, only female stand-up comedians appeared in the 1960s. Joan Rivers can be considered as one of the first stand-up comedians.
I can never get married looking like this, you know? And I feel sorry for any single girl today. The styles and the whole society is not for single girls, you know that. Single men, yes. A man, he's single, he's so lucky. A boy on a date, all he has to be is clean and able to pick up the check, he's a winner, you know that. Or a man can call up anybody in the whole world, you know that? Hello, I saw your name in the locker room, I thought I'd give you a quick call.
The topic of women's stand-up comedy for a long time has not escaped the conflict caused by gender differences. I think this is a challenge to male authority in a patriarchal society. But others believe the discussion of gender by female stand-up comedians is telling about the differences that they have experienced or observed, which are jokes made between the initial thinking of men and women.
We can't ignore that women are hilarious and making content that everybody wants to consume.
Women have an advantage in stand-up comedy because we've been dabbling in our feelings for far longer than men have. And so that's why we're killing the game right now.
As more and more third gender people come into our site, therefore, the third gender-related stand-up comedies also began to appear on stages. They switch their gender identities through appearance and posture to achieve fusion of physical characteristics. The two genders come together into one body, with new perspectives to create new creations, such as Turner Winter, who is a transsexual comedian herself. In her show, she usually won't shy away from private experience, or even the private part of her body. She uses this way to create contrast among traditional gender identities and create humor among them.
I'm so sick of always having to say that, but I feel like it's my social responsibility. Because I don't want to mislead or confuse the straight guys in the room here tonight. If there are any. Are there any straight guys here tonight? Not a single one? Can I just say, I am so happy that we have finally reached this moment in time and history where straight men are scared to identify themselves in public.
Sophie Quirk used to propose a theory. The essence of stand-up comedy is the use of what is called jester's privilege. It is a kind of privilege that the performer lowers his position in the stage performance first, and then he can freely mock others without being affected by any consequences. As for stand-up comedy, no matter the style or theme, the moment when comedians standing on the stage is for showing a unique self-poetry, or speak for the group he or she represented. The audience can as well see a diversified perspective from it.
LOLs that show up several seconds after the punchline, all but ruining the tight